addition of integers. Properties of addition of integers. Okay. Now you know whole numbers. Okay. Sum of whole number is again whole number. Sum of two whole numbers is again whole number. Okay. For example, now suppose 14 plus 7. What will be the answer? 20. 14 plus 7 is suppose whole number A. A is 14 and B is 7. So answer is 21. So 21 is also again whole number. Okay. So this property is known as the closure property for addition of the whole number.
So we will see this property, is it work in addition of integers also? Now I will give an example to you. Minus 14 plus 7. See, A is minus 14 and B is plus 7. So minus 14 plus 7. Minus plus minus. Minus plus minus. So from 14 we are going to subtract 7. So answer is 7. So it is negative. So this property work in addition. This property it work in addition. So integers are closed under addition. So integers are closed under addition. Let's see next property, commutative property. Commutative property. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Now first we will see this work in whole number. Yes. So 3 plus 2. A is 3. B is 2. Is equal to B plus A. B plus A means 2 plus 3. So what we are getting? 5. What we are getting? 5. So this already we have learned last year. Commutative property in whole numbers. Now we will see it work in integers or not. It works in integers or not. That we are going to see. So one example, I will take minus 2 plus minus 3. See, minus 2 is A and minus 3 is our B. Is equal to B plus A. Now B is minus 3 plus A is minus 2. So minus 2 plus minus minus. We are going to open the bracket first. Is equal to now minus plus minus minus. So minus minus plus. So answer is 5. For answer negative. Is equal to minus 3 minus 2. See, this is minus 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 plus. So 5. So this property work in integers also. Commutative property it work in integers also. Let's see next property, associative property. First we will see in whole numbers. See here, A will take suppose 2 plus into bracket B is 3. Okay, plus C will take 5. Is equal to A is 2 plus B is 3 and C is 5. First we are going to solve the bracket according to Bodmer's rule. Plus 3 plus 5, A is equal to 2 plus 3, 5 plus 5. So 2 plus A, 10. 5 plus 5, 10. So this it is a whole number. We have got the whole number. Let's see this property work in the integers or not. Now see, A is minus 5 plus into bracket B is minus 3 and C is minus 2. See here, A, B, C. Okay, is equal to into in bracket a plus b. See, a is minus 5, b is minus 3, and c is minus 2. So again, first what we are going to do, we are going to open the brackets. Minus 5 as it is. Now see, plus minus 3 plus minus 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 2. Okay, now minus 5 as it is, plus minus 3 minus 2 minus 5. Yes, minus 3 minus 2 minus 5.
Zero. was zero. 15 plus minus minus. So my 15 minus 15 zero.
So today we have learned
all these properties of addition of integer. Now we will learn still some properties of subtraction of integers.
Let's see
properties of subtraction of integer. First, closure property. A minus b. In addition, it was a plus b. Now we will see it work in subtraction of integers or not. Now a will take 15 and b minus b is 30. So a minus b. A will take 15 and b is 30. So 15 minus 30. So for a there is positive sign. This for 15 it is positive sign. Plus minus minus. So from 30 we are going to subtract 15. So what is the answer? Minus 15. Minus 15. So this is also an integer. So it works in the subtraction also. Now we will see next property, commutative property. Means what? A minus B is equal to B minus A. A minus B is equal to B minus A. Now suppose A, we will take A and B is 11 and there is minus 1. So 8 minus 11, what we will get answer? Minus plus minus. So from here we are going to subtract A. So answer is 3 and for answer negative sign. We will see for this side also B is 11. A is A. So 11 minus A, 3. We have got the same answer? No, it is negative and this side is positive.
So this property, it does not work in the subtraction of integers.
This property does not work in the subtraction of integers. Now today we have learned the properties of addition and subtraction of integers. Next lecture we are going to solve some examples from practice 1.2.